Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Mesillas Yesharim, and today we will finish the Hagdama, the introduction to this beautiful Sefer. And he writes, what's the reason that I'm writing everything over here? L'ma'an nilmad l'yiras Hashem Elokeinu. I'm writing this entire Sefer called Mesillas Yesharim, the Path of the Just, with all of the magnificence that we're going to discuss over these weeks and months ahead of us, is in order to instill inside of us Yira es Hashem Elokeinu. We should have the awe and the reverence and the fear of Hashem our God. And we should not forget the tremendous obligation and the responsibility that we have in front of Him. Once that there's Yiras Shamayim, once that we have this fear and the awe and the reverence, the recognition that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching over me. He's in my room, He's with me when I'm driving in the car, He's certainly with me in shul when I'm davening to Him, when I have a sefer open and I'm learning. He's in my marriage, He's with my chinuch habanim, raising my children. He's at my Shabbos table, He's at my Yom Tov table, He's at the restaurant when I'm sitting there eating a meal as well. He's at the ball game even, if I let Him in. HaKadosh Baruch Hu is everywhere. And once that I have a level of Yiras Hashem, I have this appreciation of the fact that HaKadosh Baruch Hu is watching over me, then I will not forget the chayiv, the tremendous obligation and the responsibility that I have before Him, which is namely a life of Avodas Hashem, where I serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu with mitzvahs, with the commandments that Hashem has bestowed upon us, and living a life as someone that has a focus on fulfilling the ruts and the will of Hashem. Let's not forget, says the Ramchal, that the physical nature of this world, the earthiness that we deal with all of the time, it works very hard to wipe away the Yiras Shamayim from our hearts. It wants us to forget about our obligation. It wants us to enjoy and to indulge in the physical pleasures and the desires and the luxuries of this world. When a person does that, there is no time to think about HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There's no time to stay focused and to know which direction you're moving in. So therefore, HaKriya V'Yistaklus Ya'ala Al Zichreneinu. Therefore, when a person reads the work of Mesillas Yesharim and they begin to examine and to look at things in a different way as the Ramchal will place it in front of us, it will go up on their memories, on our memories, in our thoughts. And we will be reminded and inspired and infused with a new burning desire to do that which we are commanded to based on what HaKadosh Baruch Hu has given over to us. Says the Ramchal, unless you're learning these words, and unless you're thinking about them, and unless you're mistakel, unless you're looking carefully to examine your ways and the ways of the world and what HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants in His Torah, it's going to be very hard with our battle that we have constantly against the chumrius, the physicality, and the earthiness of this, the materialism of this world. It'll be very difficult to be able to emerge on top. But if a person learns Mesillas Yesharim and other works like this, and he learns Torah, and he engages himself in spiritual matters and endeavors, as we're going to see, so then your mind's eye will be open wide, and you'll be able to see what it is that HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants from a person, and then you'll be able to move yourself constantly to the best of our abilities in the right direction. V'Hashem yeh b'chisleinu, Hashem will be our helper. He will be our support. V'yishmor aglenu milached, He should guard our legs, our pathways, milached, from any traps and any stumbling. We have to walk down this narrow path to the best of our abilities. And there's traps and there's pitfalls all along the way. How are we going to protect ourselves with every step that we take? We need HaKadosh Baruch Hu to be our helper, to be our guardian, to open our eyes, to veer us clear of pathways that are not good for us. So we're asking Hashem, we want to do what's right in your eyes. We want to be able to elevate ourselves and to fulfill the responsibilities and the obligations that you have given us. But we need your help. We need your involvement. V'tiskayim banu b'akashas ha-meshoyrer ha-ov le'elikav. And Hashem should fulfill within us the bakasha, the request of the most beloved singer of Klal Yisrael, Dovid HaMelech, the way that he sang to his God, the way that he sang to Hashem. And he said over the following in Tehillim, Hayreni Hashem darkecho, Hashem, show me your ways. Ahalich b'amitecho, I'll go in your truth. Yache levavi liyira shemecho, you should unite my heart. Liyira shemecha, to fear your name. Amen, ken yiratzayin, may it be Hashem's will that this is the way that we approach these amazing and majestic words of the Mesillas Yesharim that has the opportunity over here to be life-changing, to elevate us and to cleanse us and to give us a much deeper insight into just how glorious the purpose of our life is when we fulfill the responsibilities, when we welcome HaKadosh Baruch Hu in, when we have an awareness of Hashem's presence in our life. Then we won't forget what we're here for, and we will live a life of true avodas Hashem. Have a wonderful day. Tomorrow, Be'ez Hashem, we will start the first chapter of Mesillas Yesharim.